Good morning, students. In the previous class, we learned volume and surface areas of cuboid, cube, and cylinder. Along with we learned about cone, right circular cone, frustum of a cone, and their formulas. Today, we are going to learn pyramid concept. What is a pyramid? So all of you look at the board and picture. Observe the picture along with definition. A pyramid is a solid obtained by joining the vertices of a polygon. Polygon, constant polygon, a simple closed figure bounded by three or more line segments is called a polygon. So here, a pyramid is a solid. How it is formed? Join the vertices of polygon to a point in the space by straight lines. The base of the solid obtained is the polygon and the lateral face of triangles. The fixed point in space where all the triangles meet is called its vertex. So very simple. For example, take a triangle. It is a polygon not? Okay. Take a point on the space. If you join this point with vertices of this polygon, that means O. Okay. OA, OB, OC. This is called a pyramid. Understand? The base is any polygon and the lateral surfaces should be triangles. We can observe in Egypt pyramids. In ancient days, the Egyptian people saw pass away. After the dead bodies kept under a tomb and constructed big buildings like these structures, those are called Egypt pyramids. Nothing but what? Pyramid is a solid obtained by a polygon and joining all the vertices of the polygon to a fixed point from the space. The type of solid is called a pyramid. Understand, children? So what is a right pyramid? Right pyramid is nothing but the line joining from the fixed point to base of the polygon is a perpendicular. Is a perpendicular is called right, is called a right pyramid. Right pyramid, right pyramid. What is right pyramid? In a pyramid, if draw axis of the line from the fixed point, for example, take a pyramid children here. So, for example, take a triangle. It is a triangular pyramid. Give the names A, B, C. Okay. In case, from the fixed point on the center of the regular polygon is a perpendicular, then it is called a right pyramid. What is regular polygon, children? If all the sides are equal and all the angles are equal, half a polygon is called regular polygon. Example, equilateral triangle and square are best example for regular polygon. So right pyramid is nothing but it is a pyramid. The axis of the line from the fixed point to the regular polygon, in case it is perpendicular, that means the line is 90 degrees from the base is called right pyramid. Understand? So this is the definition about pyramid and right pyramid. Okay, next we can derive formulas about the pyramids. So look at the board and note it on the definition. So have a right pyramid with pyramid of the base P. Pyramid of the base is P. Height will be H. Slanted will be L. Slanted means side heights. Okay. Then lateral surface area of the pyramid. How to find? 1 by 2 into pyramid of the base into slant height. Pyramid of the base into slant height. In nothing but 1 by 2 into pyramid of the base. So the base will be any type of regular polygon. Okay, children. So 1 by 2 into P into L. Half PL. Next. Total surface area of the pyramid. How to find? Lateral surface area plus area of the base. So based on the base, the formulas will be changes. Base may be square or triangle or pentagon, whatever it may be. According to their base, we can apply the formula. Next, volume of the pyramid 1 by 3 into area of the base into height. Area of the base into height. Understand, children? Very, very important formulas. Lateral surface area of a pyramid of PL. For example, it is a square. Pyramid of the square formula what? 4A. 1 by 2 into 4A into slant and L. Next, total surface area, lateral surface area plus area of the base. Area of the square formula what? Side square, side into side. Plus 1 by 2 into 4A into L. Next, simplify and find the formula. Next, volume of the pyramid for square, 1 by 3 into area of the base, area of the square formula as a square into height. Height is given in the problem. So like that, based on the problem, we can use the formulas. Understood, children? These three formulas are very, very important to solve workout problems on pyramids. Okay, children? Understood? So next we have sphere is a set of points in the space which are equidistant from a fixed point. So sphere is nothing but it is set of points from a fixed point. The distance are equal. So what does it say? Sphere is a set of points in the space which are equidistant from a fixed point. The fixed point is called the center of the sphere and the distance is called the radius of the sphere. So best example, take a football. Everyone know football? In the football, middle you can image on a fixed point. From the fixed point, the distance to every point on the boundary of the football is same. It is example for sphere. Lemon, ball, the moon. Understood sphere? Sphere is a set of points in the space which are equidistant from a fixed point. It is called a sphere. Understood, children? So please note it down on your running notebook. So next, how to find surface area of a sphere? So we have one formula, 4 into pi r square. Please remember, surface area of a sphere equal to 4 into pi r square, square units. Volume of a sphere, 4 by 3 into 5 r cube, cubic units. So what is volume of a sphere? 4 by 3 into 5 r cube, cubic units. These two formulas are very very important. Understood, children? What is a sphere? So next we have hemisphere. If a sphere cut into two halves, that means half, by a plane passing through the center of the sphere, then each half is called a hemisphere. Take a lemon. If the lemon cut into two parts, each part is called hemisphere. Look at the picture. Okay, children, what is hemisphere? If you cut a sphere into two equal halves, that means equal parts, then each part is called hemisphere. So now, what is curved surface area of hemisphere? 2 pi r square. What is curved surface area of a sphere? 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square of 2 pi r square. Okay, children? Total surface of hemisphere of curved surface area plus area of the base. 2 pi r square plus pi r square. Total of mass 3 into pi r square. Volume of hemisphere. X volume of sphere are 4 by 3 pi r cube. So half formula is 2 by 3 pi r cube. Look at the picture. Curved surface area of a sphere equal to 2 pi r square. Total surface area of a sphere equal to 3 pi r square. Volume of hemisphere equal to 2 by 3 pi r cube. Understood, children? I think all of you understand today concepts. Please note it down on your running notebook, and especially mainly you can practice the formulas. Formulas are very very important. Okay, children. Thank you.